scripted within an ancient tome which lies beneath centuries of dust in the guarded library of Mechalon is the story of how the rift was formed. Though most cannot recall a time when the rift did not divide the enclave and the outlands, they were at one time unified. At that time, there were lands where the very essence of magic was believed to dwell, for they were lush and prosperous. All who did not hold the secrets of the soil, which were protected by the Pact of Jifuro, coveted these lands fiercely. The great demon Vatar was among these envious creatures, for he believed that with the magic of these lands in his grasp, he would surely become invincible. And so he led his army to attack the dwellers of the land and lay claim to it for himself. The battle raged on and on, until at last the mighty wizard Zael stood alone against Vatar to protect the lands. When all hope seemed lost and Vatar's victory imminent, Zael struck the final fatal blow. With a roar of anger and anguish, the wizard slammed his staff into the ground. The world trembled and then parted beneath Vatar's feet. A scream of outrage erupted from the demon's throat as he fell to his defeat. However, victory did not come without a price. The chasm that grew from this powerful blast of magic was too vast to be traversed, and the people were separated as much as the lands. Those who had come to aid their brothers in fighting against the demon's army returned to their home, called Mechalon, with stunned minds and heavy hearts. The Pact of Jifuro had been broken, and they had become separated from their brothers. The denizens of the Outlands, a dark and selfish people, became known as the Dreg'Atar, and the enclave of Magic Land, which had been divided from the rest, formed a peaceful city called Selenheim. In time, all wounds are healed, for in the lengthy span since it was torn asunder, it seems that the magic inherent within the world has begun to knit the land back together. The rift grows smaller and can even be crossed in certain locations. Though it should be a time of celebration and rejoicing, such is not the case. For despite the passage of time, the greedy Dreg'Atar still lust after the lands of magic. Raid after raid has been sent into the enclave in hopes of weakening it for the major attack the Dreg'Atar intend to wage as soon as they are able. Crops burned and possessions stolen, Selenheim has been thrown into a state of extreme unrest. Heavy taxes are levied upon the people to help pay for the city's defense. This has led to uprisings within the enclave, and some of its inhabitants have landed in jail, along with the true enemy. And it is here that our story begins. A few rebellious grains of sand within the ever-turning hourglass of life.